This morning, so that you are aware, we are not slaves to fear. We are not being gripped by an overwhelming sense of hopelessness today, but we are encouraged this morning. And so I wanted the song to play just for a few moments for somebody. Whatever's trying to overtake you, whatever's trying to grip you today, whatever's trying to overshadow you above the presence of God and the truth of God, you are no longer a slave to fear. You are a child of God. God loves you. God cares for you. He is looking out for you. He is hovering over your household right now. If you go outside and look up, there is a cloud. There is a protection. There is something that is over you and over your family. So you do not have to succumb to that fear. And so be delivered right now while the song is playing. You are no longer a slave to fear. So whatever is overtaking you, whatever it is, resources, money, job, family, husband, wife, you are no longer a slave to those feelings or to those emotions, to those thoughts. You are a child of God today. Accept it, believe it. You are a child of God. You are his son, you are his daughter today. And he loves you. He is embracing you right where you are. So feel the love of God, even in this moment, right now, while I'm talking, while it is playing, resonate with it. Lift your hands where you are and receive it now. You are a child of God. You are free. You are delivered. You are operating in life today. You are no longer afraid. Testify today. Tell that enemy, tell that devil, tell that thing that is trying to sift you. You belong to God. Your thoughts belong to God. Your emotions belong to God today. Everything around you, everything in your household belongs to God today. Your thoughts, your dreams, your beliefs, everything. God has it under control and he has it in his hand. So you are no longer a slave today, but you are free. So do not be fearful. We thank God today for his presence. Hallelujah. We feel the presence of God. Even while I stand here in my dining room, which has now become the church where you are the church where you are. And so we sanctify the area where you are. We sanctify your bedroom. We sanctify your bathroom, your kitchen, your living room, your space, your outside, your deck, whatever you are now. That is the sanctuary. And this is the altar that we have built to God today. And so we bless him. We give God praise on this morning, and we thank God for all that he is doing. We say hallelujah. Come on and clap your hands. You know how to send the hand clapping emoji? Send the hand clap emoji. Clap your hands. Tell God hallelujah. Tell God thank you today. Tell God, God, we believe you on today. God, we are standing firm on your strength today, God. We are standing firm on your word today, God. We believe you. We trust you. We believe what your word says. We believe what your word says about us. We believe what your word says about this whole pandemic. We believe what your word says about my household, my life, the vision, the dream that you gave me, what you spoke so many years ago, God. I still believe it today. I still need to see it come to pass. And you promised it, so you will prove it on today. And we thank you, God. Hallelujah. We thank you for the freedom that we are experiencing on today. With everything that is happening, we need to give God glory on today. We need to praise God. We rejoice on today that we woke up this morning. No bad reports on today. We know that there is calamity and there is despair in the earth, but we are speaking hope today. We are preaching hope. We are preaching joy. We are preaching rejoicing on today. Not that we don't recognize what is happening, but there is only one remedy for this thing right now, because we can't control it. But we know that God can. And so we put our trust and our hope in the God of our hope on today. And so we thank you, Jesus. We thank you today. We are a child of God. We are a child of God. We are no longer slaves. And we are no longer fearful. God, we thank you for today. We thank you for this worship experience. God, we thank you for what you are doing, even as we are separated, but we are not alone. We are yet one body, and we are one spirit. We are one kingdom. And so, God, we are connected on today. Hallelujah. I feel the presence of God. I feel the presence of your connection on today. We thank God for his presence. God, have your way in your people on today. Have your way in this service. Have your way, God, for all that you are going to do on today through me and through your word. In Jesus' name, we thank you on today. Hallelujah. Walk in freedom on today, people of God. Walk in freedom on today. We thank God in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. I see the hand clap emoji. I see you. I see you. That's Sister Annabelle. I see it. Hand clap in Jesus' name. We give God praise on today. And so we clap our hands and we rejoice for everything that is happening. We are witnessing still an unprecedented time in the earth, unprecedented time. And so once this is over, normal will be redefined. New, things will be new. You will be new. Things around you will be new. We will have new practices. And so we are preparing for it. We are preparing for how things are going to change once this is over. It has changed the landscape of our country. It has changed the landscape of our interaction and how we think and how we operate. And that's not always a bad thing, but how it is happening, it is creating despair. It has created fear, and people are being affected by it. And so we are praying for everyone that is affected. We are praying for every healthcare worker. If you are watching this broadcast right now and you are a healthcare worker, send us something so we know that you're watching, so we can pray for you. Send your name. If you know someone that is a nurse or a healthcare professional that is still working in the field, send us their name now. Put them in the comments. Let us know so we can pray for them directly. We will call out their name that they would be protected and they would be covered. If you are being affected by this in any way, we are remembering you on today. We are praying for you. We are praying that you would be covered. All that you need, God would meet it. God says that he can meet all your needs according to his riches in glory. And God is not short on glory. He has not run short. Heaven has not run out. God has not run dry. He is still God. He is still on the throne. And he is still Jehovah Jireh. He is still the great Jehovah. He is still the great I am. And so while God still reigns, we still have faith. While God still reigns, we still have joy. While he is reigning, we are still yet encouraged on today. And so we are praying for you. We are praying for you. We are praying for all of you. LACC, it is good to see you. It is good to see family and friends on today. We thank God for all of you that are watching. Hallelujah. We got up today and we got dressed to come to church. And we thank God that we have space and opportunity. They closed the doors, but we are not closed. We are not shut down. We are coming up with ways to stay connected, to keep the vision before the people, to keep the word of hope before the people, because this is a vital time to stay connected to family and friends, stay connected to people. Check up on people, check on people you haven't heard from, check on people from out of state, from other locations, and stay connected to your word. And so if you're an LHCC member, you're a part of the family, we're sending emails and we're sending text messages. So check your email every day. We are sending encouragement. Stay connected to your word. It is the word of God that is going to help get us through this time and help us while we are quarantined and on isolation. But you are not alone today. And that is the point. You are not alone. Wherever you are, you are not alone. You can connect with us. You want someone to pray for you, send your name in the comments. We will reach out to you and pray for you. We will pray for you today before we close out this service. We thank God for all of you that are watching. Hallelujah. Today we're talking about breaking news. It's breaking news. Every day CNN is on and we have a tendency to watch it and inundate ourselves with it because we want information. We want information, but we are balancing out downloading that with downloading the word of truth and the word of God. But we want to be wise during this time and we want to keep up with what is happening and how this pandemic, how this virus is moving, if it shifts, if it mutates, if it does anything different. And we're keeping up on it so we can be wise. So when things change, we can give out information to all of you and we can give out resources. If you are in New Jersey and you know of places that are offering resources, send that information to me so we can get it to people that we know. We have been helping people in Philadelphia, but we want to be able to help anyone. If you're connected to our church family, if you are part of us and you need resources, we want to be able to help you also. But it's breaking news, and so we're going to give you some breaking news today from the Word of God and from the Word of Truth, because CNN has a news break almost every day. It's a breaking news and the president comes on and talks. But I believe that God, and I know that God in the name of Jesus is still holding weight in this community, in your community, in this nation, across this world. I know the name of God is still holding weight. This is an unprecedented time and it has called for unprecedented reaction. Now, we could not have anticipated how far this would go, but now we're reacting, but we can anticipate further what will happen, what it could do. And so the church is mobilized. People are using resources to stay connected with people all across the globe. And the word of the Lord is going out. The praises of God are going out. The word of prayer is going out in an unprecedented rate. People are watching and people are connecting. And so that's the first part of the breaking news. Let's go to the scripture. When I read the scripture, somebody put it in the comments. It's found in Lamentations 3. Lamentations 3 and verses 19 through 26. Lamentations 3, verse 19 through 26. And we're going to read it. And we're reading it in the NIV version. NIV version. I remember my affliction and my wandering, the bitterness and the gall. I well remember them. And my soul is downcast within me. Yet, this I call to mind, and therefore I have hope. Because of the Lord's great love, we are not consumed, for his compassions never fail. They are new every morning. Great is thy faithfulness. Hallelujah. Somebody type it in the comments. Great is thy faithfulness. Great is thy faithfulness. Great is thy faithfulness. I couldn't get past that word. Great is thy faithfulness, God. Great is thy faithfulness. Hallelujah. God, I thank you. Verse 24. I say to myself, sometimes you got to talk to yourself. I say to myself, the Lord is my portion. Therefore, I will wait for him. The Lord is good to those who hope is in him. To the one who seeks him, it is good to wait quietly for the salvation of the Lord. May the Lord bless the reading and hearing of his word. The word of the Lord is already blessed. It's already relevant. We don't have to make it no more relevant than it is. It already is what it is because I am said that I am. And so the breaking news today, I want to read this song. We were singing this a little while ago. Never lost. He is my faithful father, calling me out of the dark. Night cannot whisper away what he said in the light. He is my firm foundation. My anchor won't be moved. Storms may collide, but my soul is on fire with his word. And when, listen to the sound of power that is on my lips. I'm not just opening my mouth and speaking dead air. When I open my mouth and I praise God, when I open my mouth and I pray, there is power coming from my mouth. And I need you in your place while you are isolated. I need you to be speaking power that comes from your mouth, because we need the power of God to reign over this. It says, listen to the sound of power on my lips. Jesus has broken the curse. He has never lost a battle. Undefeated. Never lost. He has never lost a battle. Who are you, Great Mountain? Who are you, COVID? Who are you, pandemic, that you should not bow low? Jesus defeated the darkness. He has never lost a battle. What is ever trying to loom over you today, in Jesus' name, whatever darkness is trying to come over your household, whatever darkness is trying to come over your job and speak against the power and the presence of God and the truth of God, we call that thing out now. It needs to be removed from your household, from your very vicinity. It needs to think twice before it even decides to come on your block. You better watch what you say and do to somebody who is anointed and appointed. And I need the anointed and the appointed people to stand up. I need those people to stand up and emanate today. That's the second part of the breaking news. I need you to stand up today. The power that is on your lips. Don't be down. Don't be cast down. No, there is grace that is renewed every morning. And when you woke up today, you woke up in hope. And you woke up without fear. You woke up with assurance, because God has a sure reputation. And you woke up with it. It is surrounding you. It is on you now. You left some of the residue on the bed. Go back up in the bed and grab the rest of the residue, because you need all of the power on you today. When you leave your house today, the power needs to go with you, so you be covered. So people touch you, be covered. So the households will be covered. So the stores will be covered. Just because you happen to walk in and buy some toilet paper, where you touched, there won't be infection. There will be deliverance when you touch that shelf. In Jesus' name today. Hallelujah. I would run around this dining room if I didn't get off the camera. You got to stay on the camera when you're doing live feed. You can't be running around and doing stuff like that, because people might tune out. Like, this joker done left the video feed. I ain't watching that picture on the wall. My God, today. Listen, folks. Lamentations chapter 3. Y'all got the breaking news. Listen, we're going to give you some breaking news. Listen. The word of God says, I remember my affliction and my wandering, the bitterness and the gall. I well remember them. Yeah, I do. They with me. Yeah, it's with me. What you came in with is with you. God may have delivered you. He surely delivered you. You surely are not what you used to be. But the Bible says, I well remember them. I remember them because it taught me something. I remember them because that pain, it took something from me, but it left something greater inside of me. It left a determination. It left a will to fight. It left a will to stand up and grab hold of the promise of God that is on my life. So I well remember them. But he says, I well remember. I don't let it overtake me, but I know that it's with me, because it didn't necessarily define me. It didn't defeat me, and it didn't define me. The power of God and the truth of God define who I am, but it is with me. And so I keep it. I remember it. But listen to what he says. I well remember them, and my soul is downcast within me. And so sometimes while you're looking at it and while you remember, you have a tendency to come down. That's why we post it to 5-1. That's why my wife, Dr. Brown, the great doctor, put that information out there, the 5-1. You watch the news, you see the death toll is rising and it is climbing, it is increasing, and things are starting to happen that seem to be out of control. And so we don't want to spiral with the rest of the nation, with the rest of the country. We remain in prayer and we remain faithful over fear. It says, my soul is downcast. But then he jumps in immediately and says, yet.
Yet.
Yet. You know what yet is? Yet is a pause. Yet is a hold up a minute. My soul is downcast, but yet. Yet says, you know when you look up yet? Yet has a meaning. Yet says before. So before I go down, before I spiral, before I get fearful, before I let go, wait a minute. Yet is an interruption. And so yet is an interruption to the thought that will tell you you have to spiral. It is an interruption to say, no, you don't have to feel like that. Focus on something different. Yet is a no. Yet is a suspend.
Wait a minute, suspend that thought. Suspend the thought that you don't have what you need. Suspend the thought that you need to be fearful. Suspend the thought that you're going to spiral out of control. Suspend the thought that this thing will overtake you. You will not be consumed. Didn't he say it is because of the Lord's mercies, the Lord's grace, that we are not consumed? Suspend that thought. Wait a minute. Yet I don't have to be fearful. Yet I can still go on. So keep praying, keep pursuing, keep persisting, and keep producing in this season. I'm going to say it again. Keep praying, keep producing, keep persisting, and keep going. Keep going. You will not be outdone. This enemy, this thing will not overtake you. It says yet. Somebody type yet. Yet. Type it in the comments. Yet. Before. No. You know the one that I like? The interpretation that I like the most? Non-occurrence. And so yet says, whatever these thoughts are, whatever these feelings are, they're going to be a non-occurrence. They're going to be of no consequence today. They are not going to occur. I'm going to stop it before it even has a chance to resonate with the rest of my body. Because you know it starts up here. The battle starts up in the mind. This is where it begins. And he said, listen, I'm not even going to let it. I remember and I can see it. We recognize what is happening. We're not blind and we are not naive. My wife watches CNN almost 24/7. She takes a break to eat, and then it's back on. We are not naive, and we are not underreacting, but yet we suspend the thought. It is not going to overtake us. We are watching for information, then we get the facts, but we are not fearful. And so we suspend it. It is a non-occurrence in this household. And so my children are not downtrodden. My children are like, what is going on? What are we doing? How you communicate it and how you give it so they have truth, but they are not afraid. I'm not afraid, so my household is not afraid. Yet. Did somebody type yet? Because I can't see it scrolling. I see it moving, but I can't see it. Listen, we see what is happening. We get the same information you get. And so the facts aren't different in my household. The filter is different in my household. Hallelujah. Somebody say hallelujah. The filter is different in this household because yet. I can preach all day about yet. The facts aren't different. The filter is different. You know it starts here. And so what comes in your mind comes out in your life. Hallelujah. What comes in your mind comes out in your life. And you can't fight this thing from these other angles if you don't fight it right here. And so if you don't let this thing that you well remember that you see, if you don't fight it, if you don't say, yet, I don't have to be down. Yet, I don't have to be fearful. Yet, I don't have to be afraid. If you don't fight it, then it'll overtake your whole body. And you cannot allow that to happen. You have a filter that allows you to hear the facts, but don't respond to the facts the same way the world responds to the facts. And it's not saying that we are better than you. We are above you. No, we're saying that we believe something that you don't believe. But what we believe doesn't require you to validate it. What we believe doesn't require you to accept it or not. We believe it. We know it. And so you got to think it. You got to write it. You got to rehearse it until it becomes second nature. Think it, write it, do it. Think it, write it, know it. Think it, write it, rehearse it, know it. And so today, we're talking replacing your panic with prayer. Replace your worry with worship and replace your anxiety with adoration. Focus on what is unchanging. There are a lot of things around you that are changing, but today, right now, Sunday, April 5th, on Palm Sunday, the good news, the breaking news is what is unchanging is Jesus. You know, today is the day that they celebrated the entrance of Jesus into Jerusalem and they sang Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna. Yes, Jesus is entering in. He is coming. We've been fasting. We've been praying. The nation has been praying. Even the president spoke Easter. Even in the president's body, God was talking to him because Jesus is entering in. He's coming in on the donkey and he's coming in with the glory of God. And so we are ushering him in and we are walking him in. Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Hallelujah. Praise God today. And so replace your worry with worship on today. You don't do it, the rocks will cry out. The rocks got sense enough to know, God, we can trust you. The only thing in creation that worries is us. Birds don't worry. Look out your window now. Look out your window. You see the squirrels going about their business. You see the birds going about their business. You see them operating like it's business as usual. We're the only things in creation that worry. Focus on what is unchanging today. Yeah, that's the breaking news. Yeah, we see the facts. We just have a different filter. Yeah, while you are isolated, you are not alone. Don't you let that enemy tell you that you are doing this by yourself. You are not doing this by yourself. You are not alone. But while you are operating in this isolation, this holding, you need to be preparing, making yourself better. In Jesus' name. Let me find it. You need to keep praying. You need to keep pursuing. You need to keep persisting so that you can keep producing. In Jesus' name. Then it's chaos. But in the midst of chaos, there is opportunity. I'm telling you. You came in this thing with some stuff today and this time. You need to be prepared in this time. Things that are trying to defeat you, they're trying to bring you down. Listen, define it. If you can define it, you can defeat it. If you can call it out, you can defeat it. You cannot change things that you are willing to tolerate. And God shut everything down for you to recognize things around you that are trying to bring you down, that are trying to sift you. And so if you can define it, if you have enough courage, it takes courage to do it. It takes courage to define it. But you have been called to courage because yet, it hasn't happened yet. Yet says before it happens. Yet says before it's a non-occurrence. It takes courage to call out those things that are trying to defeat you. If you can define it, then you can defeat it. Don't tolerate it anymore because you don't have to. God gave you space and time to address it. In Jesus' name. Yet this I call to mind. And what does he say? Therefore, I have hope. And so yet suspends the thoughts of fear, and then we replace that hopelessness with hope. Yes, you have hope. Hope will not make you ashamed today. Yes, hope. Hope. You can hold on to it. You can rely on it because God has a sure reputation. What he has done, he will always do. What he has been, he will be again. He can do it again. He did it then, he'll do it now. The thing about God is God will do things. Once he does it bigger. He does it better. And so this one will cause God to respond, react differently, to do it bigger and better. Hosanna in the highest. God, we thank you today.
Jesus.
God, we thank you today. Don't lose out. In the midst of chaos, there is opportunity. I promise you today. I promise you today. Listen, verse 24 says this. I say to myself, the Lord is my portion. Therefore, I will wait for him. The Lord is my portion. But the beginning part of the verse is what I focused on. It says, I say to myself. You know, sometimes you got to talk to yourself because right here is where the battle is starting in the mind. And the things around you will respond to how you respond. Because if you fight the battle here, then you can fight the battle on the outside. And so, yes, this is a crisis. But in times of crisis, this is where faith and leadership stand up. In times of crisis. Yeah, in times of crisis, it's unexpected obstacles. But I promise you, in times of crisis, there are unprecedented opportunities. Ministry opportunities. Growth opportunities. Opportunities for you to come out better and stronger than what you were. Don't miss the opportunities during this time. Don't miss it. God, I need you today. Hallelujah. 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 There are unprecedented opportunities. There are things that God is looking for you to do during this time. It says, I say to myself, you got to talk to yourself. When you wake up, today is the day. Lord, give me this day. Today I start my day in hope. Today I start my day in victory. Today I start my day in your presence, God. Today I start my day, even though it's a crisis. They calling me into work because these jokers won't get their soul right. Give me hazard pay to come in here. But yet there is opportunity here, God. I know you'll bless me. I know you'll keep me. They don't call me out of the job, so I know you'll cover me while I'm at the job. They don't shut the job down, so you'll shut the virus down while I'm at the job because I'm coming in. I'm carrying something in. Now, listen, faith doesn't say things are easy, and faith doesn't say we are exempt. Faith says that things are possible. Faith says that we see things that others don't see. And so, God, if you see fit to take me in, then you'll take me through. If you see fit to put me in it, then you'll bring me out of it. You'll carry me through it. You'll cover me through it, or you'll deliver me from it. God, we thank you today. I say to myself, the Lord is my portion. Therefore, I will wait on him. And so while we are waiting, we need to be producing. While we are waiting, we need to be prioritizing. Yet while we are waiting, we need to be persistent in our prayer. We need to be persistent in our giving. We need to be persistent in our reading. We need to be persistent in our lifestyle. This is not a time for you to shift all of what you're doing, and then the holding, when you shift it, you need to shift some of what you're doing, but you need to prioritize. And so during this time, you're not doing more stuff just for the sake of doing more. You need to be doing more of what's important. As you realize the economy and things around you are fatal and they do fall apart, you need to be doing more of what's important, more of what will be sustained, more of what will be remained. Those kinds of fruits that will stay constant in the earth when all of these things pass away. And so you prioritize, but don't just add stuff just to be adding stuff. You know, your life can be full of stuff, but then void of meaning. And you don't want to have a life full of stuff without meaning. You want to prioritize and do things during this time that are meaningful and that are productive. In Jesus' name. Jesus' name. Listen. Listen. God chose you during this time, even before this. He chose you for his anointing, right? He chose you to carry it. He selected you to carry it. And that has not changed. And so right now, while you are here in this position, while you are here, you are able to produce. God chose you to carry his anointing, and so that comes with responsibility. And so God chose you to carry it because he knows your story. But watch this. God will also hold you accountable because he knows your story in Jesus' name. Watch it. He will hold you accountable for what you are doing with it during this time, how you are increasing it, how you are working with it. You don't have little faith anymore. How you are increasing it, how you are being bold about it, how you are helping somebody else, how you're responding to your family, how you're treating the people around you, how you're staying connected, how you're helping your church, how you're trying to be of service. God will hold you accountable because he knows your story, and he selected you to carry his anointing because he knows your story, because he knows what you came through, what you walked through. The COVID hit, and the COVID is terrible. It's dangerous. Yes, it is. But the things that you already went through taught you how to be wise. It taught you how to survive. It taught you how to buckle down. It taught you how to get in the presence of God, to get in your prayer closet. It taught you how to stay in place and then trust God. You already know how to do it. That's why God chose you to carry his anointing, because he knows that part of your story. But don't miss out on the accountability, because God knows your story. Hallelujah. Somebody ought to say amen in this place. Clap your hands today, church. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I'm telling you, crisis will teach you what you value. This is the time where it tested your faith and it tests what you value. Listen. The difference between your values you embrace and the life you live, that equals the frustration you experience, because your values in your life aren't matching up. Yeah, I'm going to say it again. The difference between the values that you embrace and the life you live equals the frustration you experience. And so areas where you're frustrated, not the value, not the focus right now. Sometimes you got to cut a man. Sometimes you got to cut some things loose. Sometimes you got to cut some people off. People frustrating you. You don't need to be frustrated right now. You don't need to be frustrated in this time. You need to be focused in this time. And so things are frustrating you. You need to let it go. Your job might be frustrating you and you need those resources. I'm not telling you to walk in there tomorrow and say, you know what? Y'all can have this job. You can take this job. That's not what we're saying. We're saying be wise, but it should not be frustrating you to the point where you can't focus. This day will teach you what you value. Quick. In the last 3 weeks, we see exactly what we value. We see what you value. It's evident. It's obvious. When you tune in, when we talk to you, what you value is coming out of your mouth. Remember, what comes into your mind comes out of your life. In Jesus' name. God, we thank you today. God, we thank you today. God, we thank you. God, we thank you. Where we at? Where we at? I feel like I've been talking forever. Only been 30 minutes. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God, I thank you. We need to do this more often. Hallelujah. Listen, let's read it. I'm about to be done. I'm about to be done. I just wanted to give y'all the breaking news. I just wanted to give y'all the information today. I just wanted to give you hope today. I just wanted to give you some things to be encouraged so that you will realize and know that God is holding weight during this time. You are not a slave to fear. So I'm almost done. I'm going to read this last thing. I need y'all to stay with me. Stay with me. Stay with me. Pick your head up off the pillow. Don't drift back off. Don't fall asleep. Get up. Get your shot of water, some OJ or something. Wake up, clap your hands, send a hand clap in there. Send an amen. God, we thank you. Hallelujah. Worship the Lord right where you are. That's a great moment to worship God. Hallelujah for the breaking news that we already got. In Jesus' name, God, we worship. God, we thank you. Hallelujah. God, we praise your name. We bless you today, God. We worship. You know, worship will change your whole atmosphere. It could change your whole week. The trajectory of everything that is coming this week can be broken right now just by you worshiping, just by you clapping your hands, just by you giving God glory right now. Could shift everything that's ahead of you all this week. And you know what? You look at yourself, you think about you. What about if you worship God and praise God for somebody else? What about if you take the focus and attention off of yourself and think about somebody else that has to go out and brave these elements and brave this atmosphere and brave this infection? We worship you today, God. We bless your name. We thank you. Hallelujah. I thank you that my children are covered. I thank you that my family is covered. I thank you that my extended family is covered. We woke up today with no bad reports. We woke up today with everybody in good health. We woke up today with our resources intact. We woke up today with the ability to breathe and move freely. And God, we glorify you today. Hallelujah. We worship you. That's the breaking news of the day. You woke up today. You are in good health today. You are encouraged today. You have hope today. You have the peace of God today in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. And you have enough peace and enough anointing and enough power to speak it over somebody else. Somebody that doesn't feel it. Tag somebody. Text somebody. Call somebody and tell them, wake up in hope today. You have hope. You don't have to be afraid. You're no longer a slave to fear. You are a child of God. Let me pray with you. Let me declare it with you. Let me decree it with you in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. That's a great moment to worship. God, we thank you today and we glorify you, God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God be glorified. Hallelujah. I thank God that my baby is progressing. Hallelujah. The pain that she has, she doesn't have it anymore. I thank God for it today. I believe, God, that he is not done. He is not done because God was not surprised by COVID. It says he sits high and looks low. He never sleeps nor slumbers. He is always on guard, always on the wall, always watching over us. And so God was not surprised. Not surprised. First Peter tells us we don't need to be surprised either. We don't need to be caught off guard, and we do not need to be operating in fear. Not today. Hallelujah. Let's read the last part of this. Let's read the last part of this, and we're going to let you go. 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 It's still early. You can still eat breakfast. You can still make the biscuits. You can still make the waffles. Hallelujah. You know, I'm going to read this last part and we're going to thank God. But some of y'all are home and I know y'all cooking. Somebody put in there what you're eating for breakfast. Just give me one or two. What you eating? Some of y'all on the fast, so you probably shouldn't be eating nothing. So don't give yourself away. But you should have gave up something for the fast and replaced that with time to be with the Lord. And so what's for breakfast today? We thank God today. Hallelujah. We need humor, and we need to be able to keep this thing light. We need to be able to balance it. 5-1, people of God. And being having humor does not say we don't recognize what is going on, because we are watching. In my household, we are watching, and we are trying to stay connected as much as possible with as people we know so we can stay on top of it and so we can anticipate. We don't always want to be people that react. Listen, we are living through this. Living through it, we're going to love through it, but God Almighty, we're going to lead through it. Yes, we are. LHCC, we're going to lead. The church is leading through it. The church is spreading hope all over this country, all over this nation, and it is affecting people. We saw a governor last night said on CNN, he wrote a piece about faith. It is happening because at the end of the day, there are ills and things in this world that legislation won't cure. There are things that legislation just won't change. And it's the prayer and the power of God that will affect it and change it, and the people of God that have that belief and that faith and the stamina to see those things through. In Jesus' name. Let's read this last one. Let's read this last one. This is verse 23. I kind of went out of order. But verse 23 says, they are new every morning. Great is thy faithfulness. We can walk out the church right there. We can walk out right there. Great is thy faithfulness. Great is thy faithfulness. It don't say small or low or potentially. No, it says great is thy faithfulness. Somebody write in the comments, great is thy faithfulness. It's something that you can hold on to, that you can believe today, that you can take with you. You don't remember nothing else from this video, from this message. Remember, great is thy faithfulness. Hallelujah. Great is thy faithfulness. Listen, this is, I need y'all to hear this. I need y'all to hear this. And when I say it, somebody need to write it. It says, there are new every morning. So when you start your day in hope. Start your day in faith. Start your day with the facts. The facts are the word of God, the truth of God. That's why I send emails every day. My wife asked me, why you send so many emails? Why you send so much stuff? Because the truth needs to prevail over fear. The truth needs to prevail. The facts need to prevail, facts and faith over fear. And we need the truth of God, and the truth comes from the word of God. And so faith comes from hearing, and hearing by the word of God. And so we need to hear it, and it needs to stay around you. And as much as they're going to run CNN, then I'm going to send emails, I'm going to send information, I'm going to send it by email, because it's the easiest way to stay connected to everyone. So check your information. If you want to be connected and included with the emails and encouragement that we're sending, put your email in the comments, and we'll send you the information too. Start your day with the facts. Start your day in hope. Listen, they are new every morning. And so every morning, God has something waiting for you that he didn't have planned for you yesterday. And so your yesterday doesn't compare to your tomorrow. That's why you can't worry about tomorrow, because it says the mercies of God are going to be new on tomorrow. And so we're not trying to, listen, predict. All we're doing is anticipating. All we're doing is expecting, because it already promised that they will be new tomorrow. And so you are not the one that needs to try to have all the answers today, because tomorrow God is going to do something new. And so today will take care of today. Hallelujah. And tomorrow God has something waiting for you. And so we worship God for it. They are new every morning. Great is thy faithfulness. This is the time while we are together, while we are isolated, but we are isolated together, while we are together in our homes. This is the time where you need to determine your non-negotiables. Hallelujah. Determine your non-negotiables in Jesus' name. Somebody write it. Determine your non-negotiables. You know the non-negotiables? These are things that we absolutely won't do at this time. As for me and my house, yes, we will serve the Lord. This job is not going to kill me. You're not going to kill me, Joker. You're not going to kill me, wife. You're not going to talk me down. You're not going to talk me out of faith. You're not going to have me spiraling out of faith. You're not going to have me tied up in some futile conversation about what God will do and what God won't do. You're not going to have me tied up. God will do what he said he would do. God promised it, and he will prove it in Jesus' name. Determine your non-negotiables. These are things, family, that during this time we are not going to compromise on. Great is thy faithfulness. Great is thy faithfulness is a non-negotiable in Jesus' name. Great is thy faithfulness is a not shifting. It's not going to change. Hallelujah. And so families, men of God, determine your non-negotiables. Women of God, determine your non-negotiables in this season. It will carry you through this season. I'm not going to negotiate. I'm not going to bend. I'm not going to break. I'm not going to compromise in Jesus' name. And these are the things. You write it, you think it, you confess it, and then you believe it. Write it, think it, confess it. Write it, think it, confess it. Write it, think it, confess it. Non-negotiables. Psalm 91 hangs on my children's bathroom wall. Psalm 91. We ask them all the time, if you read it, if you read it, if you read it, rehearse it. Write it, think it, rehearse it. Write it, think it, confess it. Write it, think it. So when they get somewhere, all of a sudden one day, Psalm 91 is going to start playing in their mind in Jesus' name. All of a sudden, the non-negotiable will cause them to choose something that they otherwise would not choose in Jesus' name. Determine your non-negotiables for your household, in Jesus' name, for your life, for your ministry, for your job. Your job doesn't dictate who you are and what you do. Determine your non-negotiables, because if you have to make a decision out of wisdom, God says, I will back you up. God says, I will come behind you and back up where you stand, because if you stand on my name, then I will back you up. You just walk out of the job like, forget y'all, I'm sick of y'all. Yeah, no. But if you make a decision out of wisdom and out of faith and say, God, I need you to protect me. God is saying, yes, I'm going to step in and I'm going to have your back. I'm going to step in and I'm going to cover your resources. I'm going to step in and I'm going to cover your family. Determine your non-negotiables. In Jesus' name. Listen, we've been hearing shelter in place a lot. This is the last thing I'm going to say. How many times did I say it? This is my third one. Somebody let me know where I'm at. How many times I say this is my last one that I'm going to end? Somebody let me know. I know y'all listening. I know y'all done heard it. Where we at? Somebody said it? No, y'all not there yet. This is the last thing I'm going to say. Shelter in place. I've been hearing it. And I keep thinking, you're doing me a favor by telling me to shelter in place. Because remember the old Fred Hammond song? He quoted the scripture, he who dwells in the shelter of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. And so you telling me the shelter, you just putting me in the shelter. You telling me the shelter in place, you just reminded me what I already should know, that I have a refuge. Yeah, the name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous one into it, and they are safe. But the shelter, you know, I couldn't resist trying to see why I keep hearing it and why I keep rehearsing it in my mind. The shelter in the Hebrew, with the scripture, Psalm 91, shelter in the Hebrew is the makesa. Shelter in the Hebrew is hope. Shelter in the Hebrew is hope and trust. So you're telling me the shelter in the hope and shelter in the trust in Jesus' name? Is that what you're telling me to do? You telling me to hold where I am in the shelter, and I don't have no better sense than the shelter in hope and shelter in trust? It says shelter in place. So hope and trust in place. Y'all better stay with me in here. You better not fall asleep. Not right now. Push your wife, push your husband, tell the dog, shut up, move out the way, because I need to hear this. You better not fall asleep. You telling me to hope and trust in place? But wait a minute. Watch what place is. Watch this. It says hope and trust in place. But place is the makom. Comes from the origin kam. It means arise. So you're telling me to hope and trust and then arise. But wait a minute. It's hope and trust, but then place also means listen to God's word. Place also means become powerful. So you telling me to shelter in place? You telling me to hope and trust and become powerful? Are you serious? You telling me to hope and trust and become powerful? You telling me to hope and trust and arise more powerful? You telling me to hope and trust and arise and listen to God's word? Are you kidding me today? That's the breaking news. They done told you to shelter in place. They done told you to hope and trust and become powerful. Listen to the words of power that are on my lips today. I'm not bending. I'm not breaking. I'm in power. That's the breaking news. Hosanna forever. Jesus done arrived, and I hope he done showed up in your living room. You telling me to hope and trust and listen to God's word and become powerful in Jesus' name. Somebody write it in the comments. Hope and trust and become powerful. You are being held accountable right now. Hallelujah. God chose you for his anointing while you're sheltering in place, while you're hoping and trusting and listening to God's word. But he's holding you accountable because he knows your story. Don't lose focus. Don't lose sight. Work on your ministry. Work on yourself. Work on your mind. Work on connection. Don't lose the connection right now. Don't fall off right now. Stay connected to God's word. Stay connected to your church. Keep giving, keep sowing, keep praying, keep persisting, keep pursuing, and keep producing. Keep praying, keep pursuing, keep persisting, and keep producing in Jesus' name. Somebody write it. Keep praying, keep pursuing, keep persisting, and keep producing in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Come on, let's pray. I'm putting my hat back on because I don't have no haircut. Then it shut down the barber. Got us out here looking like Wolfman. We're going to pray. You need prayer. You got a prayer request. Put it in the comments. They're scrolling. Our pastors will see it. Dr. Macon, you're online. Look for the prayer request. My wife is online. Look for the prayer request so we can get the names. Dr. Macon, find them. Look for them. I know you are on there. Deacon Geneva, Deacon Jeremy, look for the prayer request. Hallelujah. Deacon Jeff, look for the prayer request so we can get them, so we can call out the names. We will pray for you. We'll be in prayer on Tuesday. We will connect on Thursday. Bishop King tomorrow will be on for Monday Manna. Stay connected. Find a way this week. Churches are online all over the place. If you are connected to a church, they still need your support. They need you to tune in. They need you to keep up your giving. They need you to tithe. Don't send it to us. If you're connected to a church, you have a covering, send your tithe to them. But if you are connected to us, you don't have a church home, and you want to be connected to LACC, listen, we can open the doors of the church now. I never did it while I was at the church physically. I don't know why. Deacon Jeff asked me all the time, Pastor, when are you going to open the doors of the church? I said, I don't know, Deacon. I don't know. But listen, you want to be connected to what we're doing? You can put it in the comments now. I want to be a part of this church. You can join our church from wherever you are. You're in Germany. You are in Maryland. You can be a part of our family. We will include you in everything that we're doing, and we will connect with you. We will pray for you, and we will cover you. Hallelujah. Don't stop giving. We are still operating. We are looking to buy resources and buy technology. Until God shifts this thing, we want to broadcast as much as possible. But we need the technology to be able to do it. We want to broadcast worship. Hallelujah. Nate and Q and our worship team and Angela, ready to sing, ready to get it out. Living Hope is a place of worship, and we need to get it out. But we need your support to be able to do it. And listen, we're not begging for your money. We're not begging for it. We're going to get it one way or the other. But we want you to have the opportunity and the privilege to be a part of what God is doing in LACC and Pennsauken, New Jersey, and right now in Lancaster, Pennsylvania. And so give today. The Cash App is Cash Symbol Living Hope CC. I have one, Cash Symbol DEIYAA, capital J. Give today. Give today. We need your support. Church needs your support. If you're connected to somebody else, send your tithe. Don't pull your tithe now. Don't hoard it. Don't hoard your resources. Now is not the time to hoard it and keep it. No, God is saying, let me see who will believe and who will stand on my promise. It says, I will pour out a blessing. I will open the windows of heaven. It doesn't say I'm going to stop opening the windows of heaven during the pandemic. This is the time, because God's economy is not short. It says, I will meet your needs according to my riches in glory, and heaven is not short on glory. And so the stimulus check is coming, but I promise you today, you keep sowing and you keep up your giving. God has a stimulus check that'll eclipse what the government is sending in Jesus' name. And so we're praying now. We're going to pray. Hallelujah. God, we thank you for today. We thank you for your word. We thank you for your people. God, we thank you for your people tuning in. We thank you for everyone in their respective places, God. Hallelujah. God, send your warring angels. Dispatch them now. Hallelujah. God, we speak against darkness. We speak against fear. We speak against spiraling. We speak against mental challenges. In Jesus' name, God, we speak against it. Hallelujah. God, you are all powerful and you are all knowing. And God, you have an ending date for this thing. God, we thank you today for keeping us safe. We thank you for covering us, God. We thank you, God, for the healthcare workers that are working diligently. God, every family member that is being affected, God, be with them today. We remember them on today. God, we are praying their strength and their peace on today. God, we are praying your people would remain in good health on today, in Jesus' name. God, we are praying your people would remain in hope. God, your people would remain in faith, in Jesus' name. We thank you, God, because you covered us. You watched over us. You delivered us, God. You brought us to today, and we say thank you. Hallelujah, God. We might not have been focusing on you all week, God, because of all the different places we have been pulled in, God. But today, Jesus, in this moment, Jesus, right now, God, Jesus, we have an opportunity to focus our attention as one church, one body, Jesus, as one group, one kingdom. And God, we say thank you. Jesus. We send a resounding hallelujah and amen, God, for your word. God, we say thank you today. We have a chance to focus our hearts and our minds on you, and we thank you for it. We thank you for keeping the church running, God. We thank you for everyone making sacrifices. We thank you for everyone giving. We thank you, God, that you are restoring your people right now, God, that you are renewing, you are restoring, and you are rebuilding all of your temple, all of your people, God. You said you would not neglect the works of your hands, and God is working on you right now. Right where you are in your living room, your bedroom, your dining room, your kitchen, God is working on you. You are not alone. You are not alone. God is saying, I am with you. I am in the midst of you. He is embracing you right now with a never-ending love. Hallelujah. His hand and his eye is forever upon you. And we thank you today, God. Hallelujah. We thank you for the healing that you're doing in your people. We thank you for the healing in the households, God. Hallelujah. We thank you for the jobs. We thank you, Lord, that you are protecting us that are still going out and coming in. Keep us safe on today. God, keep us under your watchful eye. In Jesus' name, we thank you. Hallelujah. People of God, type amen. Type amen. Clap your hands on today. Give God a hallelujah. We want to trust God today. Give your seed today. Give your seed. Give your seed. Send it to the Cash App. Send it to the Cash App. You can't do nothing no way, man. What you gonna do? Sow it. Put it into the kingdom of God. Put it into something that will last and will benefit you, will return to you. You should have bought you some chicken and some steak and some beef so you can cook your food. We support the restaurants, and so when you can, show support, show love to people. You may know some people who work in a restaurant. You might know some people who own a restaurant. Support them when you can. Sow into your church. You ain't got nothing else to do, man. You can't do nothing, Craig. So send your money, post your money, post it, send it. Send it. Support your church. If you're watching and you're part of another church, listen, people of God, send us an offering. Send your tithe to your church. In Jesus' name, send it. We thank you today. We thank you for watching the post. Living Hope, we miss you. We're giving a shout out real quick to Alicia. I got my Black Girl Magic stickers. Y'all see that? Diggin' Geneva's daughter has a business. She sent a beautiful card with it. I don't know if y'all can read that. Got my name on it. She took the time. People are producing during this time. You know how to sew. You want to be able to give. Make some masks for healthcare workers. We can make them as a church if you want to do it. We can put together food. We can do whatever it is you want to do. Innovate during this time. Innovate. Crisis causes people to lead, and it causes you to focus your attention. You know what crisis has the ability to do? It has the crisis has the ability to have a centralized focus. And there are very few things that will produce that in your life, and you want to take advantage of it. Produce during this time. This young lady opened her business during this time. She probably didn't have time to do it before, but she sent it, and they're beautiful, quality. Make some masks. Make some medical equipment. Get some things out to people in your community. If you are in New Jersey, you're connected with us, and you know people who need help and need resources, let us know, and we will find a way to get food and supplies to people. Check on the elderly. Check on people around you. Check on them. This is how we stay connected. Mask up, glove up, and check on them if you have to. Call them. Get people connected on Facebook. Told my mom and dad the other day, get on Facebook, get on live. You need to get on Zoom so we can see you, so we can check on you, so we can look at your face. Hallelujah. But we thank God today. We thank you for watching. Go in peace today. Go in hope today, people of God. The breaking news of today, great is thy faithfulness. Hallelujah. Be blessed.